Rise and Shine to Sunshine Radio 96.7, Saturday mornings. This is Voice from Veterans and the rest of us who say we support veterans too. News, commentary, information, education, music, and entertainment. New just for you, 96.7. Now, you've heard the rest. Stay tuned for the best. Rise and Shine to Sunshine Radio, and stay with us all day long.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year, everybody. This is the Airman with you for Voice for Vets. This is our New Year's Day show. Welcome to 2022. Today's show, we're going to play some of our favorite interviews and other topics from 2021. So, please sit back, strap yourself in, and enjoy the show.
Good morning, Vietnam! It's just a smidgen past 5 after 6, and here we go with another day's version of the Don Buster Show from Armed Forces Radio. I'm Airman Adrian Kronauer, and for the next 4 hours, we've got the best in popular music for you here, so let's get started right now with music.
Adrian Kronauer. If you don't remember that name, it's one of my inspirations that got me into radio. You remember Robin Williams did a tribute and a historical movie called Good Morning, Vietnam. That's when I was in San Francisco. That's when I was in college. It was a big movie, and it inspired me to go into radio. So the two biggest inspiration for me was Adrian and Paul Harvey from Chicago. Good Morning, Vietnam is an iconic story. All of us who were alive during that period remembered the controversy that came. And the movie made a difference because it brought a real picture to what was going on. So we want to thank all of those. And if you haven't had a chance, if you're young enough and you don't remember it, go back, find the movie, enjoy it, and understand why radio still exists and will forever, and especially on Mother's Day. Listen to your radio. We'll all be talking about our mothers. And that is Sunshine Radio. And I say Radio St. Pete online. So I want you to stay tuned and enjoy today's program. Today's program is going to be divided into a couple of sections, and I'm going to do something that I promise. Today's program, and I want all veterans to call one of their friends, especially their female friends, and tell them to tune in, because this show is all about our women veterans. You know, we have decided that over the last 25 years that a lot of things changed in the military. And in 20 years, we know, because we just shut down the war in Afghanistan. But what happened for 5 years before that? And when we had Kuwait and we had Iraq and we had other skirmishes around the world, what we found was that the military stood up and said yes to a lot of women. And again, I don't mean nurses. I mean women who had other skills and women who wanted to be trained, women who came out of situations just like men, wanting to make their lives better, and chose the military to get them to that point in life. The main thing is, when a woman gets out of the military, what does she have? Well, she has the same options as any man has had. The difference is the VA is gearing up. The cities around America, Tampa, Florida, San Francisco, California, Los Angeles, all those places that have the big bases, and of course, everywhere around the middle of the country, around the Chicago area, Dallas area, all those places who have a lot of women, who took a lot of women into those areas, have stood up. The states, the counties have stood up and started making ways for the female soldiers who went and battled with the men and made a difference in the world. We know that the compassion that comes with women is one thing, but they found that when it came to snipers and other specialty services, women fared better. So we have a lot of respect for the women. What is survival skills for women? Survival skills for women workshops teach women the basic day-to-day life skills. These skills will help them learn how to better manage your own household with money, health, and the behavior of education of your children. They will help gain the confidence needed to take charge of your life as you move toward independence. Yes, that's one of the goals that we know stand. The women can stand up now, and they have help guiding them. A lot of these young ladies who went into the military went in at a young age. In the old days, you called them young women. They went in as young women. And as young women, they had some learning to do. And most of them learned very well. Some of them learned better than others. Some of them chose military careers and are still in. But some of them chose that their life had gotten better and needed to come home to raise children, to be a good spouse, to be on their own in business, to have a guidance that they knew that they had to do. So we salute those women and say that there are, of course, programs now to help veteran women as they make this transition back into civilian life. We know that that's important, so we're going to stand with them with that. What I want you to do is take a moment and look around and see what you have that you can offer. And if you can, offer it to the women. This program have groups of 8 to 15 women take part in a role-playing skill practice and activities that make up these sessions. In these classes, you'll win special prizes, be given handouts with useful information, have a chance to learn and practice now new skills, and make new friends at the compilation of workshops and certificate compilation is awarded along with special incentive gifts. All this is available with Survival Skills for Women. And of course, that's right here in Pinellas County, Pinellas Opportunity Council, POC. And they offer these programs along with our Veterans Administration Office there at Bay Pines. So you get a lot of help. This is to strong women. May we know them. May we be them. May we raise them. That's a slogan that's put out, of course, by the POC right here in Pinellas County in full support for our women veterans. Again, women veterans make up a little bit more than this, than 10%. I think it's more like 18% of the veterans coming out are women. That's quite a few women. If you got 100,000, that means it's quite a bit. And you know that there are a lot of women out there who have served this country and do well. We always praise Wanda Wade, who's over there at one of the churches in Tampa, Without Walls. She's a major, and she does a lot to make sure that the women veterans get anything that they need if they come to that church. This is a local business, but I'm going to go national for you right now. When you look at the women veterans all around this country, they are some of the best potential persons to employ. And we know right now that they're complaining about a lot of people not taking the jobs. Now that unemployment's gone, I'm sure that a lot of people who weren't working will be working. I'm telling you, employers, put the word out. Of course, you'll take anybody. Please come in and apply for the job. But look out for our women veterans. They make the best employees. They're loyal. They have strategic ideas that will make your work better. And they bring something with you that nobody else. A unforgivable understanding so that you know that the knowledge they have will do you some good. So we want you to stick to this station. Tune in. Radio St. Pete, St. Pete Radio Online, if you're in our area, for more information. And we're going to be talking about workshops for these women. This show is dedicated to our women veterans, and we want to thank everybody who does support our veterans. Veterans Services And we're really talking about the services that come with the homeless. There are a few homeless veteran women. They need special help. If you happen to find a veteran woman down there, log in. If you can't help them, call the station, let us know, and we will put somebody on that for our women veterans. If you stay with us, we're going to take a little bit of time, and we're going to talk about some of the workshops. The workshops are very important because it gives our team, our county, our people a chance to do what's necessary to make sure that the women veterans of this country get the right service. And we know in the state of Florida, they've done their job. And around Georgia, all over the South, Southeastern, the New Orleans area, we especially want our women veterans to be taken care of because of the hurricane season. We have a lot of women veterans who work with FEMA who stood up to the test, and they're over in that area now helping clean up. So we know that we don't have to worry about the women veterans doing their part in any of our disaster areas. They do their stuff better than most people. The first one on our area that we're going to talk about is assertiveness. Learn about every woman's Bill of Rights and how to stand up for yourself and still respect the rights of others. First workshop. You know, a lot of times because you came out of the military and you run into some of your military friends, they're also very respectful. But if you run into civilians who don't understand your value and what you learn, sometimes they can be a little bit coarse. We want you to know that there's a way to get around this. It's called how to adapt your assertiveness when you're a woman and you need to be respected. Those classes are wonderful. They are part of the program of Survival Skills for Women, and it's compiled in these 10 workshops. Now let's move on to the second stage, personal health. Learn how good and bad nutrition habits affect your health and what you can do to change bad nutrition habits to better ones. Change those bad nutrition habits to better ones. There are not only grocery stores that now have complete healthy sections, but you have health department areas. We want you to know that that's very important. Pick the right stuff at the right time, and I'm sure that you will feel better. And when a person feels better, they act better. When you act better, you offer more of what's good when you do something. The third one kind of follows the second one, nutrition. Learn about the food guide pyramid and how to plan for and serve healthy meals and snacks. Learn what food labels mean and how to get the most out of your food money. That's very important. The cost of food is going up, and it will continue to go up. We know that we don't have to worry about it because there are plenty of places that offer good discounts, but get the good discounts on the quality food. We're going to go back to something we haven't done in years because we do too much stuff on the internet, but get that Wednesday paper, pull the coupons, okay? You know they work. They still work. Pull the coupons. Get a coupon file going because it can save you a lot of money, especially you women with children. You need all the help you can get with saving a few dollars as you purchase not only food, but your home needs for those children. And you get you some vitamins to pick up where some of the nutrition has it. And as you learn, you will learn how much better it is for you. We're going to take a moment break here, and then I'm going to come back with the one subject that we all want to talk about, and that's money management. Be right back. Hi, this is Keith, the boss of the beach, and it's WVETOnlineRadio.com. One of the things I want to say is veterans resources. And as always, we say if you're having a problem, especially emotional, go to Veterans Crisis Line, 1-800-273-8255. And that is Veterans Crisis Line, 1-800-273-8255.
I'm bringing music for the soul, cause there's nothing left. Trying not to stress, bills piling on the front steps. Majority spent on the groceries with your last check. Trash through my face mask in the basket. Seems the whole world wants to see me in the casket. Before I blast it, sky's the limit and I pass it. Time to go away to God, guess I take my chances. Hey, he ain't trying to take all that and try to bully you until you grab a baseball bat and say, gee, won't you take all back? You probably lose half of your fans if you stayed all facts. I say to those cats, rather pick a side than stay in between. You don't agree, cool, but don't try to intervene. And keep your distance 6 feet if you need to. A disclaimer, you take a chance when I greet you as tree. Just so you know, I will never change no matter how cold. Just so you know, I will never change no matter how low. Just so you know, I will never change no matter how.
Welcome back. That was a nice little break, and I hope you enjoyed that interlude. I always do my little breaks with a little music. That was a wonderful song, and I called it Golden Soul. He's a local artist, and we really appreciate Gino Lexus for what he brings to the table. And he says, we support veterans too, or our women veterans. Survival skills for women. And we were talking about that earlier. And I wanted you to get those activities because there'll be a lot of women there. And we want to make sure that they get enough time with you standing at a booth or with you coming to do a booth and stopping those veterans or women and helping them in their directions. Now, money management. Learn how to do a simple monthly budget and improve your shopping skills and spending habits. That's something that we can all do. But especially now that a lot of our women are returning, and they're returning with spouses, non-spouses, mothers, fathers, cousins, and everybody. But it's back to your responsibility to do these things. And because you were in the military and you had a steady income that was minimal, but it was regular, hopefully you learned some of those skills and it came to pass. But if you're going to refurbish, start all over again, see what you can do to make a difference, believe me, money management skills are very important. Now, let's move on to one of them that's more important at some point when you think about the things that you need to be looking at. Child management. What does that mean, child management? Learn different ways to manage your time with your children. It's simply that. Learn different ways to manage your time with your children. In this day and time, between Facebook, Yo Book, MySpace, DaySpace, Instagram, Winstagram, we don't want our children to be stuck on a cell phone, laptop, or a computer when mommy is around. Please take time with your children and do quality learning and quality time and quality entertainment. Child management skills. That is one of the workshops that comes along with the program. Now, Pinellas County Opportunity Council, Survival Skills for Women. If you happen to have a young child, you're just getting back, and you want help with developing this, try, of course, one of those conferences, one of those meetings, and one of those workshops. Self-advocacy. Learn how to set goals for yourself and how to reach them. Years ago, I'd read a book, Think and Grow Rich, and it talked specifically about one thing that I remember and used it all my life: goal setting. The old saying that is, if you don't know where you're going, you can end up anywhere. So true. It's very important to set goals. And I think that the women of this world probably know it better than the men. But here's a way for you to hone that little talent inside you. Set yourself a goal. Set goals for you. Set goals for your children. Set goals for the things you want to accomplish. And I promise you, you will reach them. Legal rights. This is a workshop that I think a lot of people need to go, because things are changing. COVID made a difference, and things are changing. Learn steps to take to prevent and solve legal problems. You know, I'm going to diverge for just a minute and talk about the COVID situation. And I know in a lot of states and a lot of areas, there's still the question of whether or whether or not you should get a shot. Well, that's a personal choice. But I just had another friend who didn't take the shot pass right here in Fort Myers this weekend. They regret not getting the shot. The family regrets them not getting the shot. But we send out our prayers for those who don't have it. Please rethink why you're not getting it. Consider getting it if you can. If you cannot, and you decide not to, we still send you our prayers and our hope for the best and pray for the rest. We know that COVID-19 has made a change in this country that will exist from now on. We want to be a part of that change. We want to make sure we're here to help those who survived through this. And that's another reason we talk about self-advocacy for women. A lot of men are going to die and leave these women with the children and everything. And if they died from COVID, there may be some other things that you'll get. And that was what I'm talking about. So feel free to look up, go to your local areas where you talk about health, and see if there's some new information on the COVID situation that you should know, especially protecting your children when school is now back in, football games are now full again, and everything is opened up. We hope that it stays open, and we learn that it will if we all do the right thing. All right, copying some of the ideas that you get off of the internet in relationship to what you should be doing is good. But then once you got the information and you're struggling with it, we say, coping with crisis, learn to plan for an emergency. And of course, we know there's a veterans crisis line. I always give out the number, please put it on your refrigerator. Get you one of the magnetic signs. Call them. They'll send you one for free. Call us. We'll get you some. Please put it on there. If you happen to have a potential of a crisis, first thing to do is put the crisis line number right there where you can get to it, just like that little emergency button that you're supposed to push if something happens. Don't forget, we're all here to help. And this is WVETOnlineRadio.com, along with, of course, Sunshine Radio and St. Pete Radio Online. Radio St. Pete Online. You can tune in anytime, day or night. Of course, our programs are on in the middle of the day on Thursdays and early Saturday morning. We want you to rise and shine with Voice for Veterans. Now, community resources. Women, if you're listening, if you're a man listening, write this one down. Community resources. Discover agencies and resources within your own community to learn how to take advantage of these services. Please feel free to take the time and do what you know is right. Go ahead and get all of the community services you can get. And guess what? There are quite a bit where we are. There are a lot of community services available, and it starts right here. Of course, on our side of the bridge, Pinellas Opportunity Council. And especially those survival skills for women, they're available. They have plenty of stuff to do. And we want you to know that we're here to make sure that you can get all the help you need when doing these things. Now, the last one, but probably at this point the most important, is reentry employment. Think about what for your future. Think about what's for your future and how to go about getting and schooling and training needed to get the job you want. We made it. Everything's good. Think about what you want for your future. Again, we'll go back to setting goals. We go back to all of the things we did, how to cope with crisis, money management, nutrition, personal health, and of course, assertiveness. All of these classes are available at Pinellas Opportunity Council. We appreciate it. And I go down to see them right there, right around the corner on the same floor, right there for our Veterans Affairs.
All right. It's the Airman again. And we're wrapping up the show. And have a blessed New Year's Day. And we're going to be changing our website from WVETOnlineRadio.com to OnTheAirToday.com. OnTheAirToday.com. We're in the process of building it. Check it out. It's still going to have a lot of features that WVET did to make the website more user-friendly. As promised, next week when we come back, we're going to cover the benefit rate increase for 2022. And we'll do a deep dive in that. And Keith will have a lot of information for you. So please stay tuned to 96.7 Radio St. Pete, Sunshine Radio. And enjoy your day. Thank you. This is the Airman signing off with Voice for Vets.
Don't forget, there are plenty of activities, plenty of things coming, and you will be a part of this every time, rain or shine. Tune in. Keith, the boss of the beach, WVET Online Radio, and we expect you, if you're here in the local area, to call a friend. Tell them to tune in. Nothing but the best, and we'll take the rest. Keith, the boss of the beach, and we're going to say one more time, we love you. Over and out. Rise and shine to Sunshine Radio 96.7, Saturday mornings. This is Voice for Veterans and the rest of us who say we support veterans too. News, commentary, information, education, music, and entertainment. New just for you, 96.7. Now, you've heard the rest. Stay tuned for the best. Rise and shine to Sunshine Radio, and stay with us all day long. Thank you for listening.
Well, I want to thank everybody for tuning in this morning. And of course, this is Sunrise. And I always say sunrise for my people at the St. Petersburg Chamber of Commerce. Thank you. And again, 96.7 Sunrise Radio. Sunshine Radio. We all love you. Don't forget, tune in every Saturday and every Thursday, noon on the internet. But for you listeners out there in FM land, 96.7 FM, Sunshine Radio, St. Petersburg, Florida. Over and out.